I'm standing here in front of one of the windows in St. Eugene's Cathedral, and as you can see, if you can see up close, it's that scene in the Gospel where Jesus welcomed children. The apostle said, get those children out of the road, but Jesus says, let them come to me, because it's to people like that that the kingdom of God really belongs. So I'm conscious that life has been very strange for many of our young people, not to mention their families, but particularly for the young people. The routine of school, your friends there, the sports clubs, all the things that you were able to learn in that context, you've lost many of those. And for some young people, one of the big things they will miss will be either First Communion, if they were at that particular stage in primary school and national school, or confirmation. And I know people have been building up for those major sacraments for months, maybe thinking about it for longer than that, when an older brother or sister had gone ahead of it before you. It's difficult for you, because that was a day I'm sure was going to be very significant, because grannies or grandas and aunts and uncles and neighbours were going to be there. It was going to be a big celebration of an achievement in your lives. All we can say is that we're all very sad that it's not been possible yet for those ceremonies to take place, but resting assured that they will be, as soon as possible, they will be celebrated for you, because Jesus is looking forward to coming to you in communion. The Holy Spirit is just waiting to fill you with his gifts for your growth in faith. So rest assured that even if things are difficult and there's disappointment in your life and the lovely clothes you had aren't going to fit you whenever the time comes round, don't worry about that. The most important thing is that the Lord is keen to come to you and the opportunity will be provided. So in the meantime, keep praying. Find a little quiet space in the house. Have your own sacred space where you can go in. I know it isn't always easy in a house with other children or with adults, but find a little space where you can be with the Lord, who's looking forward to coming to you in a new way, either in your First Communion or through the sacrament of confirmation. And there's that little prayer that we all know very well, which may be of some help to you. You know, the glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit and so on. That sums up in many ways the journey that you're on, because in St. John's Gospel, we heard that God so loved the world, he sent his only Son. Then we say, glory be to the Son who wants to come to you in communion, and then to the Holy Spirit who wants to make of your body his temple so you can be a bearer of good news to whoever you come in contact with. The day is coming. It's put off for a while, but the Lord is still keen to come to touch your body with his grace. So can we say together, glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end, amen. Keep looking forward to the day. The Lord is looking forward to coming to you on that day as well.